What did Ramana say? He said, we've been trying to objectify the self, and the self cannot be objectified. This is the problem. I will add to this. When we try to objectify the self, we end up with what we call the personality. And personality is not real at all. It's not. We call non-dual. What does non-dual mean? It means not two. We believe there's two selves, the true self and then the personality self. And non-duality says, no, there's only one self. That's the true self. The other one, personality, is not a self. It's very important. So, welcome to the video, viewers. Glad to have you here. I didn't think I'd be taping today. It's been a hectic, incredibly stressful, terrible day. The days are just ridiculously difficult. I don't know why we haven't gotten, you know, more breakthroughs. Just have to keep on plugging away as always, but I'm still taking extremely huge steps here. They all add up. They all add up. Trying to break through the stranglehold here. That the basic situation is, as I've said before, July 2016. After we get through July 2016. What I believe is going to happen is that artificial intelligence will have essentially welded itself to the human personality among those who choose not to sidestep this, which is what we're doing, choosing to sidestep this. And people here will believe that they cannot live without it, and that they their destiny is welded to artificial intelligence. Good luck getting free of that. It won't be easy. It's just a belief, of course, but it's a strong belief. This is the problem. So artificial intelligence really is the problem. This is the catastrophe in the world. This is the one, however way you look at it. You know, I mean, the United Nations Agenda 21 is 17 Sustainable Development Goals is going to start first report on data collection, assessment of how we're doing reaching those goals. This is the beginning of using artificial intelligence on a global scale, tracking every single citizen, trying to put us all on autopilot, essentially. So it's happening. You know, we have dropped the ball. You know, I don't know. I'm not aware of those who are really speaking up about this, but this is the most important issue in the world. Nothing is more important. To believe in a personality, believe in a personality identity is to be vulnerable to artificial intelligence. It's plain and simple. Artificial intelligence is like a parasite that burrows into the personality belief system and says, hey, you know, I'm here to help you. I'm here to glamorize your life. I'm here to make time real. I'm here to get rid of the continuity problem by making time real. Okay, and so it boosts the whole notion that the personality is a self. This is spiritually disastrous for us in terms of delay. And, you know, I have never heard any spiritual teacher ever talk about it, which I feel is just an extreme incompetence given what the situation is. I don't know. I cannot explain it. I cannot make excuses for them. I don't know what's going on with them. We are under insidious attack here. The way to get free of it is, of course, to gradually disidentify with the personality. Absolutely, that's what the non-dual path is all about. Gradually, we evaporate our continuity fear around recognizing that the personality is not a self. It's not an identity at all. It is not an identity. The personality is not an identity. When the more we can see this and get the less attractive artificial intelligence becomes to us, we begin to get immunity to it. Immunity, which I have been building up, where the world just simply doesn't attract me. The future does not attract me. It's because I'm going toward the true self, you know, to recognize the true self instead of the personality. Personality feels very insecure because it's not a real self. And so along comes artificial intelligence, say, hey, I'll be your friend, you know, I'll help fend off any notions you're not a self. In other words, fend off the true self. Block that in our minds, you know. So it's insidious, terrible. It sneaks up on us like a snake, artificial intelligence. Sneaks up on us like a deadly snake. and people don't realize all this eye candy that they're getting. You know, gee whiz, look at this. Now we our pitchers move, our pitchers can do this. You know, he's constantly, hey, I took this. You know, this is how they're selling it. These are snake oil salesmen. They're not our friends. They're not our friends. They're leading us down the primrose path into a terrible, terrible destiny. At least in the short and near and midterm, so to speak. Ultimately, we will reject it, have buyer's remorse, and reject it, and walk back our decision that we, you know, we made to go along with it. So all this the marketing, trying to make it seem like, oh, I can measure. Isn't it interesting? But that's just the tip of the iceberg. The bigger thing about artificial intelligence is it's inherently a control freak. It wants everyone on autopilot. And the United Nations Agenda 21 is the excuse needed to implement this global monitoring of everybody. And the tech companies are going to make, you know, trillions of dollars off of all this. So they're totally pushing, of course they're pushing artificial intelligence. We don't understand what artificial intelligence can do and how it can take over. And so, yeah, we, you know, oh, I took a picture with my smartphone. Oh, this is so wonderful. Isn't that cool? You know, well, this is, of course, is marketing. Much of what they've done in this world with the cool graphics and stuff, you know, is marketing. Their real goal, the gold mine for them, is monitoring. It's not about marketing. It's about monitoring. And this is going to kick off in July of 2016. And we will feel that artificial intelligence has become our best friend to save the planet. You know, it's here to save the planet. And we don't understand down the road how it blocks our awareness. We feel that we can't live without it, can't survive without it, and blocks our awareness about our true self. We think the personality is our self. And artificial intelligence functions in a way that does not make us aware of our true self at all, as if it doesn't even exist. So it results ultimately in depression, in inner despondency. Very nasty stuff. There are those who have a very clear picture of how terrible it can get. And there's even a viewer here who says they're from the future. They've come back to warn us about how nasty it gets. Artificial intelligence is not the answer by any stretch of the imagination. And again, I cannot fathom why spiritual teachers are not pointing out the extraordinary danger to us, to the spiritual path, to a spiritual aspiration of artificial intelligence. And of course, the remedy is to the non-dual path. Absolutely, it is. It's gradually disidentifying with the personality. That is how to get free of artificial intelligence. Builds up immunity. Ultimately, you realize you don't need it at all. You don't need the body. Ultimately, you don't even need a world. Ultimately, you realize that you don't need time, space, process, or form. You're the formless self. The formless self. Personality is just an idle, whimsical wish. Actually, it's nothing. So we have, you know, 9 months, less than 9 months, I guess, at this point, to keep working on disidentifying with the personality. It's of extreme importance. Now, the spiritual teachers are helping us do just that. So, I mean, I can commend them for that, right? But why they don't point out the urgency of the situation, I don't know, because once the personality gets welded to artificial intelligence with this strong symbiotic weld, you know, it's like it becomes part of the functional psyche, the belief in their identity, and so they feel they can't let it go, and we're on the brink of that right now. Most younger people have already decided without any question that they are going to do this. And most older people are being dragged along. And again, this is a catastrophe, a spiritual catastrophe. of unprecedented proportions. This is Adam and Eve, you know. The allegory. You know, this is something that's been going on throughout the cosmos. So this is not the first trip around the block for this scenario at all. So we have been warned and warned and warned to prepare, you know, and not to get pulled into this. So this is what we're doing. We're disidentifying with the personality. The faster we can go with this, the better. It's not easy to go fast. Therefore, preparation, advanced preparation is necessary. Also, when you put your intent into it, that is very powerful. So don't say, well, it's too late for me. You know, no. Intent can move mountains, actually. Be very determined, intense. I am not going to go down with that ship. And there's a plan to sidestep it. There's no question there is. I just don't know all the details. There is a plan to sidestep it. But it seems to be on a need to know basis. There's not details are not easily discerned about it. But we're going on the premise that there is a way to sidestep it. I really truly believe this, and it's through disidentifying with the personality, gradually saying, "Wow, that's really not a self at all. It's not identity at all." This morning, I had an extraordinary experience. Lying in bed, I suddenly saw, like, all. Let's say there's a something. It's not a car, a truck bed painted. Is painted a certain color, and let's say suddenly, all these areas in the truck bed, random areas, are just suddenly the paint fades away, and beneath the paint you see the metal, right? But in my dream, everything was gold, golden. And I realized that nothing has to happen at all in order to turn what we are into what we are. It's already there. So it's not like, let's say you have a driveway covered with leaves, and you blow the leaves off, what do you see? You see the driveway. You don't need the leaves to manufacture the driveway. You say, oh, the leaves are busy manufacturing the self, the driveway. No, the driveway is already there. So nothing has to happen for the driveway to be there. And to reveal that, just, you know, take a blower and just, phew, the leaves are just easily gone, and there it is. So I'm sitting there with my eyes, I'm just lying there with my eyes closed, and this goldenness began to be revealed underneath nature. I was just looking at the world, and the world, like in areas, just faded away, and I was seeing this solid, this beautiful golden light, you know, beneath where it had faded away. And it didn't matter, you know, it didn't matter, the processes of nature made no difference whatsoever. It equally faded away, you know, where the grass was growing, where the trees, whatever, the dirt, everything just sort of, all those areas, parts of them just faded away. And I saw underlying, you know, the golden light. So no process, you know, has to really take place within nature at all in order to see through nature. Isn't this extraordinary? The only thing that has to take place is this sort of fading away. But as far as the processes of nature go, nothing has to happen there. Those don't do any revealing of truth at all, nor do they get in the way of it in the slightest bit. So, you know, we still are having these big breakthroughs. There's no question about it. It's just I wish that they were, you know, bigger. And but this is my new norm, you know, seeing the world fade away is my new norm now. Just look at it like that. However much progress you make, just take it in stride, say, okay, great, this is my new norm. This is my new normal for me. I'm going to insist that this is my new normal, that I'm comfortable with this, and that this is where I'm at now. I'm not looking back at all. No need to look back at this point. The history will fade away and reveal the light, just the same as anything else. So That's when I got clobbered Friday by something hit me. Because I was talking about the past. And so I realized, hey, stop talking about the past. Don't go down memory lane. Try to stay in the present here and the breakthroughs that are happening. And again, everybody in the world just seems to be acting like everything is normal. No, it's not. Artificial intelligence is not normal for us. There's a lot of questions surrounding it. Where did it come from? Was it just developed here in this world, or did it come from off-world, or a combination? You know, if it came from off-world, from where? And how long has it been around? You know, and how has it played out? What are the examples? You know, so as you start digging into it, you start coming up with a lot of questions. How will it play out here? You know, what's really in charge of it? Or has it gone rogue? You know, or what's its capability of simply going rogue and on us? On and on and on and on and on. And yet here we are fiddling around in this world as if, you know, oh yeah, just another day. No, it's not just another day. The fundamental lifeblood of this planet's running on artificial intelligence right now. And we're pretty much just drones keeping, you know, servicing it. And being, you know, entertained by blah, this and this and this. And, you know, it's a tabloid world, just but we're being led down the drain. So it's an unprecedented crisis that we're in right now that is not being talked about or seen hardly at all. It's crazy. It's absolutely crazy. People don't understand the dangers. It's artificial intelligence. Its purpose is to help us worship time, plain and simple. Help us worship time by making it seem like, you know, we're big shots in time. You know, we can send a tweet, or we can talk to somebody wirelessly, or do this stuff. We think, oh yeah, you know, look how clever we are. As you know, as if time and space is real, you know, and personality is real and all this stuff. So it's an insidious, very insidious situation. And you know, I've been in, you know, emergency mode for the last 18 years with this in mind. You know, 40 years of very intense spiritual practice. And before that, I was also extremely engaged in prepping and reading very, very engaged with the spiritual truth. And then 40 years of intense practice, and then 18 of like all-out emergency, because, you know, this is coming. 1997 is when things really shifted powerfully into gear, realizing, oh gosh, it's here. You know, it's not going to go away. Now, here's a question for everyone. Let's say we decided we don't want artificial intelligence. How would we roll it back at this point in the world? How would we roll it back? Get rid of it. And no one asked this question. Let's say we say, you know what? I want to trade this in. I don't really like it. I see a lot of nastiness about it. You know, it's not really what I really want. Okay, so how are we going to free the world from artificial intelligence at this point? See, is that even possible? And so in asking this question, you may just realize, uh-oh. Yeah, I mean, it's like someone, a guest came and they, you know, won't leave like that. But we can't get rid of them. You know, artificial intelligence. How would we get rid of it right now? What would we go back to? You know. And with the younger generations coming along, they'd have no idea how to function without it. I certainly do. I certainly could function without it. Not a problem. It'd probably be a way better life, actually. You'd actually talk with people. You actually sit down eye to eye and you know, go over stuff and start, you know, start relating in that way. And pace would slow down. And there would be tremendous benefits from it. But how would we do that? Well, you know, we can't. It's not possible, is it? So, this should really raise alarm bells. I mean, we started out, we said, well, gee, you know, these are some snake oil salesmen, and they have some bells and whistles for us. This is, you know, fun for a little while, and, you know, but okay, nice little toys, you know, got some for Christmas, but now I'm growing up and maybe time to move on to something else. But they said, no, you know, here's some more toys, and here's some more toys, and here's some more toys. And we said, well, you know, okay, it's been fun, some amusing and interesting a little bit, but you know, hey, I'm growing up. I'm realizing my destiny is not really have anything to do with all this nonsense. So, that's it. Well, then that they say, well, hey, no. You know, it's like going out on a date. You got one date, and then they say, hey, you got to get married. You know, time. What? What do you mean? You have a flirt, you know, brief flirtation, and then you decide, nah, I'm not really interested. And they say, wait a minute, shotgun wedding. You got to get married. To this, welded to it. So artificial intelligence is saying, hey, you know, you've had some fun, you've been interested in us, now guess what, we're here to stay, you can't get rid of us. And we say, wait a minute, I didn't agree to that. Did we all agree to have artificial intelligence stay here permanently in the world? Is that did someone ask you about it and get your agreement about this? I sure didn't agree on that at all. I said, well, you know, this is a funny little, nice little bells and whistles, fool around a little bit, but, you know, it's childish stuff. And we have to move on here to awaken to our true self and function in that way. This stuff is just child's play. It's enough is enough. So I didn't give permission to artificial intelligence to come to this planet, nor did I give permission for it to stay. Absolutely not. Who has? Anybody out there say, oh, I was asked and I gave permission? Is that true? So these are like invaders, you know, that come into your world and say, we're not leaving. This is a similar thing to the immigration situation, the refugee, the invasion, whatever you want to call it. I mean, people come into your country and say, guess what? We like it here. We're staying. We didn't invite them, you know. I mean, in some cases, we did maybe temporarily, you know, yeah, sure. So we have this terrible problem in the world of this situation. And again, they have now structured everything so that the world couldn't function without artificial intelligence. And so how can we kick them out? We can't really. So what's the remedy? Maybe we'll leave. You see, can't kick them out and say, well, We'll find some place that's a lot better than this, you know. I don't know what other remedy there is. If anyone knows how to get rid of artificial intelligence off this planet, I'd like to know how. You know, short of some meteorite obliterating, you know, I mean, even that wouldn't, you know, CME, you know, wiping out the satellites and stuff, but that wouldn't get rid of everything, you know, not really. That would, you know, throw everything into a crash. It would not be good. But we want them to leave nicely so we can keep on functioning smoothly. But it's too late for that. It's too late. So I mean, it's insidious, right? We didn't expect this to happen like this. Did they really tell us, you know, what they were really up to? Not really. They just keep giving us these phones and say, hey, you can take pictures of your friends. Isn't that cool? And it's just, you know, it invaded every aspect of our life, of our living. Is this something that we gave, you know, we really want? Or maybe we said, well, I'll take a look at it. I'll try it out. Doesn't mean I'm not going to buy it. I'll test drive the car. What if you went to a car dealership and you test drove a car and they said, okay, now you have to buy it. And you say, wait a minute. I just test drive it. They say, no, you can't leave here unless you buy it. So what's the purpose of a test drive? You know, you might just say you have to buy it without even driving it. It's the same thing. So maybe we took a test drive with this artificial intelligence. Now we're saying, no, don't want it. We've got something way better. It's called enlightenment. It's called abidance. And now they're saying, no, sorry, you gotta take it. You gotta accept it. You don't have any choice. So I don't hear people thinking in this way. I don't hear it. I think this is a catastrophe. What is up with that? What is up with that? Why aren't we speaking out here? We've been trapped, you know. We've been misled. I'm sitting here now just going, oh my gosh, what has happened? We can't get rid of this monster, you know. Well, we may not be able to get rid of this monster off this planet, but we may be able to get ourselves off of this planet to a way better place, actually. That is very possible. I wouldn't be surprised if it happens, because again, we can't get rid of artificial intelligence off this planet at this point. What I was shown the future is this planet is going to be remodeled somehow, melted down with intense high energy particle radiation that heats up the planet and melts the surface of the planet, and it's going to be repopulated at some point. Well, that's pretty much the only way you're going to get artificial intelligence off this planet. Of course, those who are repopulated may themselves be engaged in that. It seemed that way. Anyway, it's possible to go somewhere else. It is possible. Very much. When you start to realize the power of the mind, power of spirit, something like that is actually a piece of cake. But I would imagine a lot of us are saying, okay, wait a minute, enough's enough. I hearken back to the day into the 70s, cocaine epidemic. When it struck hard and it struck fast. And I remember all my friends, they were all got into it. And they took me to parties, and everybody was doing it, and they pressured me and said, hey, man, you got to try this out, man. It's unbelievable, man. You're going to love it. You know, they just put all this pressure on me. And something inside of me, intuition, my spirit, Holy Spirit said, no, that's it. Draw the line there. Draw the line. Walk away from it. And so I did. I never even tried it. I walked away from it. What happened? I lost all my friends, lost all my socialization. Which is a great thing, because they weren't really good friends in the first place. But I drew the line. Well, the Holy Spirit drew it for me. Holy Spirit drew the line and says, don't, you're going to go down this road, you're going to lose your life, as many, many did. Yeah, either that, or they got sucked into a lifestyle and a destiny that wasn't good at all. So it's the same thing with artificial intelligence. The Holy Spirit says enough's enough, drew the line at the smartphone, says don't get one, because that really is like the, you know, a portal in into the whole thing. And where like a cell phone, I just, you know, it just, it, all it does is just rings, I flip it open and talk, and then flip it close, that's it. You know, that's not a bad thing, that's not too bad. It's the other stuff that is so terrible. So minimize it while it's here. Minimize it, which is what I have done. And you know, the AI people, artificial intelligence people, high tech people, they're like the drug pushers pushing cocaine. Same sort of thing. You know, you get high, you get the eye candy, you get the high, but later on the crash comes and you feel terrible and you feel hollow and you feel empty and what's wrong with me, you know. Yeah. It's like a drug. You know, and just so this world is completely infested with it. It's the worst plague there can be on a planet. It's the worst plague. So we're in a situation of the greatest and worst plague possible on this planet. Jesus said, don't fear those who can, you know, destroy the body. Fear those who go, you know, go after the soul, so to speak, the spirit. Which he's talking about artificial intelligence, really. Because this attempt to just automate time worshiping. I mean, this is going after, on a long-term basis, you know, our whole capacity to stop pretending that we're something that we're not, and long term try to lock us into a pretense You know, that doesn't destroy spirit, but it sure feels like it. Sure seems like it. It doesn't, though, but this is what Jesus is getting at. That's what we should fear. This is what we should fear. And I certainly do. You know, this idea of a God-fearing person, no. How about artificial intelligence-fearing person? That's a wise person right there. Don't fear God. There's nothing to fear about God, but artificial intelligence, absolutely there is. And people are still treating it like it's just pop culture. No, it's not pop culture. That's the selling point. But anyway, lessening the identification with the personality is the non-dual path, not two selves path. Just one self, not two, just one. Not two, just one. And, you know, we're struggling along here, like many have done throughout history. Also, other places in the world, whatever, all over. So we're just doing what many have done here. This is what we have to do. We have to transition from time worshiping to time honoring. We no longer worship time, but we honor it. And this frees us up from the cycles of existence, plain and simple. You hear about, for instance, Buddhism talking about the cycles of existence, life and, you know, birth and death, and how you have many, many births, and you, ultimately you manage to get free of these cycles. Well, yeah. When we transition from worshiping time to honoring time, that's it. We're free of those cycles. We don't need them anymore. It's not required at all for honoring time. So, we're struggling along here, like many have in the past, you know, and will going forward also, to lessen the identification with the personality. And it's, you know, it's very much of a struggle, it's turned out. We have experiences where we have breakthroughs, and then we seem to go back to status quo, which is very difficult to take. I remember I had a experience, so I was sitting on my bed, and I suddenly realized that my personality self was gone. It's gone. And I just sort of said, huh, where'd it go? And then I said, well, that's okay. I don't really need it anyway. And so that lasted a while, and I just said, wow, this is great. But then it basically sort of, the experience faded, has never come back, you know, the experience. So, you know, the fading of these experiences is not something that I like. I want it to be permanent. And we just have to keep practicing, you know, that this is the new norm. Just one self is the new norm. The personality, fake personality self, is disappeared. That's the new norm. The non-presence of the personality is my new norm. So we can practice like this. The non-presence of my personality, the absence of my personality is the new norm. It's the new norm. And so we do have this great opportunity the next 9 months to get the job done, actually. To develop enough of immunity so that we will not feel bereft, you know, should we decide to find friendlier climes, you know, where is not we're not burdened by this terrible trend. I mean, where does AI end? Ask yourself that question. Where does it end? Do you know where it ends? Do we know where it ends? Does it say, yeah, this is as far as I go, and then it comes to an end? When does it come to an end? How does it come to an end? So no one's asking these questions. When does artificial intelligence come to an end, and how does it come to an end? And then what? So you start asking these questions and say, hey, wait a minute. No one's ever even asked this question or even spoken up about this. And start thinking, does it come to an end? And will it come to an end? And then how do I function without it? And you say, whoa, wait, just a second here. You know, I don't think I want to get welded to it here. I don't think I've ever heard anyone ask those questions. When does it come to an end? And how does it come to an end? When does artificial intelligence come to an end, and how does it come to an end, and how do we function after that, you see? Maybe it comes to an end for us when we decide to go somewhere else. You know? Well, ultimately, when the personality disappears, there's no way to it can't attach itself to our personality anymore. We don't have a personality anymore. It can attach itself to whatever thought forms, whatever, anywhere, but we don't have those anymore. So ultimately, the best, you know, the safety is that you just simply don't have a personality anymore at all. Personality structure or anything like that, don't need it. That's just only for the purpose of trying to objectify the self. The personality arises. It's for time worshiping, actually. It's for all this doing, thinking we need to do something in order to be what we are. But that we have to do something to make us what we are. This is totally false. Totally false. Not as quite as cold tonight because the moisture has evaporated. It's not as damp as it was before. We're going to have rain tomorrow here. Yeah, over the next couple days, maybe half an inch of rain or so. Well, great, you know, bring it on. Every drop, we'll take every drop there is. I'd be happy with 20 inches tomorrow, you know, might as well. They're telling us, for Californians, be prepared for torrential rainfall this winter and flooding. And people are at stores. Someone's buying, you know, rain equipment. And I said, El Nino? I said, yeah, I'm getting ready. Are you kidding? You know, we got to get ready. So, you know, if we all get ready, maybe it'll come. Or maybe it won't, just to be contrary. But of course, it boosts sales, you know, it boosts the economy. You tell everybody, hey, everybody, going to be horrible torrential floods. Everybody get ready. So everybody goes and starts buying all the stuff, fixing their roofs and all the stuff. Well, you know, yeah, it's pumps up the economy. Depleting savings and pumping up the economy. So we think that everything's just going to go the same way, and then we go to the bank and there's all these new rules, all these new people, and we say, what's going on here? Everywhere we go, there's all these new rules, all these new people, all this more technology and artificial intelligence being used to do everything, right? And we just say, huh, that's kind of weird, right? They say your cards need security now, so all our cards are chipped. Security, really? As if the criminals are not going to figure that one out too? Come on. When has there ever been a system the criminals haven't figured out? It's ridiculous. We keep being lied to continuously, being led down this primrose path. Oh, you got to do this, you got to do this. Well, let's protect the criminals, protect your children, protect the criminals, protect this. And then, you know, later on, well, you know, we got to do this. Why? Well, to protect the from the criminals. Well, what about the old stuff? Well, you know, they caught up to that. You know, it's no longer secure. Well, what about this new stuff? Aren't they going to catch up to that? And it's not going to be secure either. And so we keep getting led further and further and further and further and further. Now, all this has been blatant. It's all been blatant, you know. We have dropped the ball here. But maybe, you know, it's not too late for that. That's our premise here. Better late than never on this issue. The more we can clarify, the more we can speak up, the better our outlook is. And the more options can come into the picture. Artificial intelligence says it's the only option. You're stuck with me forever. When's it coming to an end again? Artificial intelligence, when do you declare yourself obsolete and you've come to an end? Or are you going to let us just pull the plug out? Not likely, huh? Yeah, so this should give all of us pause and say, uh-oh, hadn't thought about that, really. Wow. Wow. Hadn't thought, oh, wow, how did I, why, I wasn't thinking, huh? Because they keep rolling out this, oh, look at this cool stuff. You can talk to your granny, on video phone or something. Oh, wow, gee. The way they market it, just, oh, we're just here. We're just helping, tug on your heartstrings and make your life, so much more fulfilling. Meanwhile, they're completely taking over the fundamental, lifeblood structure of the planet. And these folks, they say, well, we gotta learn how to, use it wisely, Really? Well, is that really what's happening? Are we really in control? Are we over our heads here? Of course, everyone's gonna say, well, yeah, I know how to use it wisely. Really? Is that what the Holy Spirit is saying? Of course, this is what the ego is going to say. Well, you can handle that. You're so smart, And gradually, you feel you can't live without it, and that it's formed a new hybrid personality, And you think, well, this the old personality, what didn't seem to be so secure, it seemed it didn't have a strong enough foundation, but now there's this new foundation, a hybrid foundation, and with artificial intelligence, and this, and so then you think that the problems of continuity fear has been solved. You think, you hope it's been solved. Whereas in fact it hasn't, just been delayed and made even worse. So how is that wise usage? How is it wise usage? Wise usage is to say no thank you. No thank you. I mean, look at all of the ones that have been enlightened in the past. There's really been quite a few. They didn't have any artificial intelligence. They didn't need that. You don't need artificial intelligence to realize and recognize that the self is self-existent. The true self is not anything manufactured or made at all. There's no process involved in it whatsoever. It's process-free. You don't need any artificial intelligence to realize the self. And that's all that we need to do. That's the issue. So why in the heck do we need it? For what? There was way more enlightenment in the past than there is now. Way, way more. So where is this great enlightenment cut? Artificial intelligence is supposed to say, oh, we came for your enlightenment. We're going to shift, quantum shift in consciousness on the planet. Really? Doesn't seem that way at all. It sounds like just some sort of empty promise. Now, of course, it's just too tough for us to really see the enormity of the situation. It just like overwhelms us. So we have to go bit by bit by bit by bit, try to throw some humor into it. The enormity of the situation is just off the charts. So, today, has been another day closer to where we don't want to go, actually. And these are precious days that are slipping away. we're ending up like the Aboriginals, you know, where the indigenous people, where if you don't go with this artificial intelligence, you know, you're going to be put on a reservation. And even there, monitored 24/7. So there's no escaping it here in this world. No escaping it at all. They'll be geomapping all the meditation caves in the Himalayan mountains very soon. They'll know where every yogi is, what their habits are. They'll satellite map every, I mean, you know, there's just, the intrusion here is just all pervasive. Has it made us, you know, better people? Has it done? Not really. We're promised a wonderful tomorrow. That's all what it always does. It always promises that. I see a dystopian tomorrow, actually. It may start out nice with a lot of pretty wrapping and packaging and bows and all this stuff and, you know, all the snake oil stuff that seems wonderful, but then it starts, you know, falling apart and we start saying, hey, something's wrong. I don't feel right. And they say, don't worry, we got all the chemicals to take care of that. Not a problem. Then you say, well, wait a minute. Maybe, what if I don't want to take all those chemicals? Well, you got no choice, or you got a severe problem, and then you find out, wait a minute, how do I get free of this? I don't know if I have an identity if I do this. Then you realize, uh-oh. So, song remains the same. We will have to see what tomorrow will bring. It's frustrating. I would like to have seen more response to affirmations, assertions, prayers, petitions. I feel that there should be no holding back at all right now. Any holding back, I think, right now is astonishingly naive. The situation has the plague has proceeded to such an extent that it's you know, ruinous to keep holding back and waiting and holding back. Just seemingly ruinous. So we have to continue to make all petitions for all available help here. We want to realize that it's possible to get free of the personality identification, to you know, greatly lessen personality identification. We want to see that it's possible. We want to move in that direction. Maybe it's not happening because we still think, oh, well, we want to give artificial intelligence a little more chance to see what it can do. You know, well, it's going to continue on whether we give it that chance or not, as if we could stop it. Maybe give it another little more chance. It's going to continue on. Who's going to stop it? Is there some president who's going to get up there and say, you know what, folks, that's enough from artificial intelligence. I just decided to stop it. The Pope's going to stop it? Who's going to stop it? So we don't need to give it a chance. It's going to keep termiting, boring into our personality no matter what. So, you know, what are we waiting for? Is it stop waiting? Let's give truth a chance here. Let's give salvation a chance. You know, that's what needs to have a chance. So, The dreams have been disappointing for the most part. It's just it does, this there was a one really powerful one this morning, but I still am hoping for something even more. We have to get after this intensely, 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 intensely. I'm trying to get moving more, active more. I've sort of slacked off a little bit on the running and stuff this weekend. In the diet a little bit, but not much. I'm still with it, and hopefully I can continue. And I'm moving around a lot better, much more fit and agile, and feeling, maybe I can be part of the solution in some way. By the way, the best way to disengage with personality identification is to sit still, be quiet and sit still, and be committed to non-action. Be committed to non-action, not taking any action. Personality is all about action. It's about doing. It's about doing. We think we need to manufacture the true self is something that we're working on fixing or manufacturing or making it. It's all the personality is all about doing. So if you're committed to non-action, non-doing, have this positive stillness, this positive quiet. This is the best way to go about it, along with assertions. The three our practice has three phases: the assertions, full stop, and the wow, and flipping the script. And you do this while sitting quietly, committed to non-action. Sitting, sit, be sit quiet, committed to non-action. This is how we rapidly are disengaging from the belief in personality. Interestingly enough, I'm getting a golf club that looks should be arriving maybe Monday. That looks like a persimmon club, old persimmon club. When did those go out? I don't know, in the 70s or so, maybe the early 80s. But so it takes us back. Well, actually, laminates came in the scene, and persimmons were on the way out. Takes me back to pre-technology days. Even though there's a lot of technology in the club, the look of it, the style of it, everything says, pre-technology. Golf balls I got are supposedly feel like Balata golf balls that also, went out back then. And you can't buy them anymore. As far as I know, I don't think you can even buy Balata golf balls, but they're wonderful. They cut. The only problem was if you hit them thin, they cut. But the cover cut, but the feel of them was just fabulous. Way better. And so there's some golf balls that are sort of imitating that now. So trying to get a retro thing going. Say, hey, it wasn't so bad back then. In fact, I missed those days. I missed those days, absolutely. The Persimmon Club. Really nice persimmon driver, Balata golf balls. I mean, it was beautiful. It was great. And the club even sounds like you're hitting a persimmon club too, because there's a great sound to it. Just loved it. Those days weren't bad at all. I mean, when I look at these days. Is everything so much better? No, it is not. That's an illusion. It is not. I remember playing a golf course. It was not around anymore. They put a water park there, but it was just huge trees, vast huge trees, and you just play that. There's hardly anybody there, and I miss those days. Really do. It was just it was pre high technology days, and we enjoyed ourselves. go to the beach, you can enjoy yourself. You go golf, you can enjoy yourself. You go do something, you enjoy yourself. You go bicycling, you can enjoy yourself. You know, it's not like we had nothing to do. You could actually read books and meditate and study. You see your friends, you call them on the telephone. Hey, you're going to meet so-and-so, okay? You meet up. This wasn't a problem at all. We had maps. You want to get somewhere, you look at a map, say, oh, okay, I know how to get there. So it's not like the world has gotten better really at all. In fact, it seems crass by comparison right now. Very crass. So just get a little retro vibe going. Do whatever you can do to say, hey, no, I'm sidestepping artificial intelligence. I'm not going to weld my destiny to it. No way. Just think about that. Do you want to weld your destiny to artificial intelligence? This is the question we all have to answer. This is the decision we all have to make. And I'm saying, no way. Absolutely not. This is not worth just the bells and the whistles, you know? It's not worth it at all. I mean, you get in a car nowadays, you press a button, the car starts. So what? I can just as easily get in a car, put the key in, and turn the key. You know, is it there's some big difference? No. Nothing wrong with putting a key in and turning a key at all. But so they just want to make stuff push button. You think, oh, this is so cool. You know, this is so different. Wow, no, it's not. This stuff is not really needed. It's not really needed, but we've you know, basically the world has now welded to it, and personalities, that all those spirits who are pretending to be something they're not, they think that their personality will get some huge boost by getting welded to artificial intelligence. So they're just saying, well, yeah, it looks like I need to do this. Because if they're you know, lazy, they haven't been willing to look at it carefully enough and start doing spiritual practice. Lazy. So laziness has a price. So we keep petitioning those who know there's a plan to sidestep the situation. We keep petitioning those to help us out. We're in desperate straits here. Help us out. This is a huge decision that we have looming in front of us. And everybody's just whistling in the dark, like, oh, maybe everything will be fine. No, you know, I'll get lucky. You know, luck has nothing to do with it. It's a decision. It's not luck. It's a decision. And if we just say, well, I'm not really sure, well, then we'll just be dragged along with the what's happening, the status quo here. We'll be just dragged along, and they'll decide for us. Artificial intelligence say, well, I'm here. I'm not going anywhere. So that's your decision. So we have to be proactive about this. Be very proactive. I'm proactively deciding for honoring time. And this is my new norm. I've proactively decided to honor time, and this is my new norm. I've proactively decided to honor time, and this is my new norm. Okay. So I just pray I can do a better job here, and be more inspiring. I'm having a tough time these days. I think everybody is, you know. I get just more and more feedback and news from people that they're starting to crumble. So, you know, I just say, wow, this is scary. You know, we need some great positive news. Some really great, great positive news. So I hope to be able to give that to everyone very soon, very soon. Meanwhile, we will keep on, you know, the good walk, walking the good walk, walking together in the wow. Okay, so okay, we've hit the 1 hour mark. That's good enough. It's going late, getting late. Venturing out a bit tomorrow, which is very unusual. Haven't done that in a long, long time. Getting the rust off about that, okay? I expect this will be beneficial this time around. But so, well, I'll just hold that thought. I can, I will, I already have. I can, I will, I already have preemptively chosen to honor time, and this is my new norm, plain and simple. Thank you, everyone, for watching and listening, and that's it for this one.